Hello and welcome back to another old-fashioned pickup video shot on a budget price mobile phone featuring low-price bargain basement items. That was a mouthful, wasn't it? Sounded far easier in my head than it did when I put it to video. But with that being said, I've just been out in my new van that I've bought, big purchase, to get some new tyres. Unfortunately, there's a slight issue with the CV boot, so it's going to have a bit more work done on it. But that's, by the by, that's nothing to do with this video. But I should probably show you that van at some point. But I'm sort of in the process of converting it into a bit of a camper type thing. Not something that you can live in 24/7, but a nice little day van or an addition to a camping trip, just so you can get, you know, dry and warm and put your head down if you need to. So, music in the background, Mike Oldfield, Tubular Bells. Whilst I was getting the tyres fitted, I popped around the local town centre, a few charity shops, and I actually went into CEX, which I don't generally do, so I don't usually go to this place. I don't usually have access to CEX. And as much as I have sort of slated them in the past, comparing them to crack converters and the like, I must say they had a very interesting selection of games. And I was quite impressed. So, charity shops, bought a couple of CDs, two for a pound. I found the first one and thought, I'm never going to get another one in here. And then I just looked up and there he was, Mike Oldfield, looking out at me. So this is Mike Oldfield Earth Moving, which I don't know too much about, but it looks relatively trippy on the background, and I must say I am quite a fan of Tubular Bells, so looking forward to checking this out. And it comes nice and complete with a fairly thick inlay. Looks like at least 6 pages of premium grade cardboard there to flick through whilst listening. There's a rather nice goldfish on the back. So there we go. And the last CD, which is actually gaming related, unbelievably. Now I realise that this was actually a box set with 7 CDs, but there was only the 1 CD there. And it's Grand Theft Auto Vice City, Fernando, which actually happens to be my favourite radio station anyway. So that's Emotion 98.3, if you weren't aware. And the track listing on this is pretty epic, gotta say. Toto, Africa, Jan Hammer, Cockett's Theme, John Waite, Missing You, Cutting Crew, I Just Died in Your Arms, Rio Speedway, Keep on Loving You, Night Ranger, Sister Christian, Luther Vandross, Never Too Much, Kate Bush, wow, it's just wall to wall hits. And of course, it features the sultry tones of Fernando, a love machine. So that was it for audio CD pickups. So CEX, wow, they had loads of PlayStation 2 games. They had some really good ones. They had Steel Dragon EX. It's a shooter, that was £12. Nearly bought that. But then I thought, come on. Steel Dragon, is that what it was called? Did I say it was called Steel Dragon? I thought I said it was called something else. Steel Dragon EX, anyway. People would probably say, should have bought that, £12. Not a bad deal, but I was going in cheap because I've been spending massively sorting this van out. So I'm going in for your £1.50 bargains. That's right, Downforce. Now, I remember when this came out and I was curious about it. I believe it's a cel-shaded Formula One type game. And for the paltry sum of £1.50, nice and complete, I thought I would take a punt. And here we go, an adrenaline fueled high-speed racer, blistering acceleration, 21 tracks, challenging opponents, 7 game modes, get ready to burn rubber. So, you know, if that doesn't whet your taste buds, then I don't know what will. So sticking with the £1.50 theme, it's Fisherman's Challenge from Konami. And who doesn't love a good bass fishing game? So I don't have a rod for the PS2. I don't know if this game is compatible with a rod, but either way, I'm pretty sure that it would be a decent fishing game, because the Konami fishing games on the PlayStation 1 were also really good. So there we go, everything included, big old bass, and another one that will be sure to bring a smile to my face when I get around to playing it. So last but not least, I've actually been after this game for a while, never really took the plunge and bought it on eBay. I think it was probably a bit more than this cost, which was £3, and it's Fahrenheit. And I believe this has got something to do with the team that developed a PlayStation 3 game that I played. Now, was it The Last of Us, or was it something else? I've actually got it in the loft, even though I've not got a PlayStation 3, I've got it in a box. I can't remember what the game was called now. I'm sure the few people who are watching this are probably screaming, saying, it's this game, it's that game. But I can't remember. But either way, I've heard good things about this. And, you know what? It's going to bug me now. Something to do with like paper mache or something like that on the front cover. Origami, the origami thing. I should know, it's an amazing game. Maybe it is called Last of Us, I don't know. But anyway, look forward to trying that out. 15 certificates, so be warned. If you see that streaming, make sure you are over that age. So that's it for now. A trip to CEX. A free paper bag, which will be handy whilst wandering around. And some fantastic bargains, I think. So that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Hopefully upload some more videos soon. Take care.